Hello and welcome to another Cloudwards video review. My name is Mauricio and today we are going to talk about sync.com. Sync is our favorite cloud storage platform right now and I'm really excited to tell you all about it. If you're looking for a cloud storage service that takes security seriously and you don't like your files hosted in the US, sync.com might be for you. There are a few downsides which we'll discuss in a minute as well, but before we get started though, please take a moment to like this video with a thumbs up and also subscribe with the subscribe button and hit the bell to get all notifications from our channel. Okay, let's talk sync.com. As cloud storage becomes more important to people's online lives, you may be a little concerned about security. Moving files into the cloud means handing your data over to a third party and trusting them to keep it safe. Sync.com's whole cloud storage service is built around security. It's full of features designed to keep your data safe from hackers and leaks. That's why we like it so much and why it's ranked at number one currently in our rankings. The most important security feature on Sync's platform is called zero-knowledge encryption. Without getting into the cryptographic weeds, zero-knowledge means that Sync encrypts your files with a cipher that even they cannot unlock. They store your files, but only you decide who gets to read them. The encryption itself is AES-256, which you've maybe heard described as bank-grade encryption. It's the industry standard and it's pretty much impossible to crack. You can also set up two-factor authentication so people who get a hold of your password cannot access your files. I also want to mention versioning. Sync saves backup versions of your files once a day in a case any of them get taken in a ransomware attack. You can access the backups going back 30 days for each file. Now, being this secure means Sync has had to make a few trade-offs. End-to-end zero-knowledge encryption slows everything down in the web app. It also makes it hard for Sync to include third-party integrations like Office or Google Docs, which means it's a bit less useful as a team collaboration platform. Sync could also definitely improve its UI. Now, it's not like it's unfriendly. It's a pretty standard Dropbox style pattern and system. You've got a folder in the drive that you can use to see your files, change your settings, or access the web app. The problem is that moving files is really a little bit unintuitive. Instead of dragging and dropping files like most users naturally want to do, you have to move them basically using a menu. That's one of the things we like most about it though. Sync.com makes the hard choices to keep your data safe. It's awesome to see a cloud storage service that's so uncompromising about security. Sync also has the best pricing in the industry. You can get 5 gigabytes of storage without paying anything, which is one of the best free plans we've ever seen. If you upgrade to the $5 a month plan, you get 200 gigs. To put that in perspective, you could store about 50 HD movies on Sync before you got near the limit. I won't list off every subscription level, but I do want to mention that the highest solo plan gives you 4 terabytes for $15 every month. That's a lot of high-definition movie that you can store in the cloud. Speaking of large files, Sync doesn't place any limits on how big a stored file can be. While size limits on Google Drive and Microsoft OneDrive are really high, but they do have limits. On Sync's Pro Solo Plus plan, you could upload 3 1.1 terabyte files if you wanted. So that's a little bit about why we're so into Sync here at Cloudwards. It's the most secure, affordable cloud storage service out there right now. Just beware of slowdowns caused by the end-to-end encryption and don't expect it to be something it's really not, like for example, a collaboration platform you might be used from Google Docs. If you use Sync or you've got another favorite cloud storage, let us know in the comments below. And if you have any questions, I'm more than happy to help you out here in the comment section below or on cloudwards.net. And one more time, if this video helped you out, don't forget to like and subscribe to spread the word about Cloudwards. I'll see you next time here on this channel.